Episode 11 of my ranking of all Beatles songs ever. Number 77 is, I just wanted to say, is an interesting song, but from now on each song is interesting and each song is a classic. Now it's really getting like into a territory where everything is brilliant and stroke of genius. It's by George Harrison, Within You, Without You, the first song on the second side of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. I told you before that at first George wanted to contribute only an orphan song to Sgt. Pepper, the album, which later ended up on Yellow Submarine. Within You, Without You is clearly the better song, but I always thought that Only an Orphan Song would have also been good. The perfect Sgt. Pepper to me would be an album Within You, Without You and with Only an Orphan Song. I think Only an Orphan Song fits on Sgt. Pepper because, people always talk about the concept of Sgt. Pepper and that there's not really a concept, but the initial concept was about the Beatles, their childhood and North England. So that's also why they wrote Penny Lane and Strawberry Fields initially for the album. So it would have been much more like a real concept album had it included Penny Lane, Strawberry Fields, and Only an Orphan Song. But I don't know why I'm talking about Only an Orphan Song because now I should talk about Within You, Without You. It's a great song. It was, I think, the Indian parts of that song were recorded in Bombay at the EMI studio in India. And George Martin then added European style string arrangements. So it's a mix of classical music from India and classical music from Western Europe, so to speak. And the lyrics, of course, are the outstanding part of it. There are hardly there aren't many George Harrison lyrics that are better because it's really one of his deepest, most philosophical songs. Yeah. Within You, Without You. 76 is Because from Abbey Road. Again, a song influenced by classical music. This time it's influenced by Beethoven. So after Rollover Beethoven, now it's a pro-Beethoven song, so to speak. It's basically the melody is the moon, what's it called? The Moonlight Sonata backwards, the chord just inverted. And of course, it's the song with one of the most brilliant vocal harmonies of John Paul and George. It's almost an a cappella song. Great song from Abbey Road. Number 75 is also Abbey Road. It's Golden Slumbers. Great lullaby kind of song by Paul McCartney. And again, it's that's by accident. It's not like I made this up because of that, but there's also something that has to do with classical music about that. The inspiration to that song because Paul McCartney he can't read notated music and before when he wrote that song I think he visited probably his father in Liverpool and his father had some sheet music on the piano and it was a song called Golden Slumbers but Paul couldn't read the notation of course so he made his own music to the lyrics so the lyrics are like 100 or 200 years old lullaby lyrics and the melody is by Paul. 74 again from Abbey Road. It's Oh Darling. Oh Darling, again Paul McCartney, classic, as I said at the beginning of the video, from now on each song is a classic. Oh Darling, very blues influenced song. John Lennon once said he would have liked to sing it. he wanted to sing lead vocals on it, but that would have been strange because in 1969 it wasn't like they were they had that kind of relationship at that time. And I think, you know, Paul McCartney sings it perfect, so I don't know what John Lennon would have made better about it. 73 is from the Let It Be album. I think I've got it here as well. We all, of course, know the Let It Be album. It's by Paul, Two of Us. Yeah, it's again, I repeat myself, a great song. It's the first song on Let It Be. Paul, in the many years from now book, said it's about him falling in love with Linda and how they deliberately wanted to get lost when they drove the car and Linda said to Paul, "Let's get lost and let's put the map away." So it's about their adventures in the English countryside, but you know, on a subconscious level, of course, it may as well be about the John Lennon Paul McCartney relationship, especially the line, "You and I have memories longer than the road that stretches out ahead." That can't be about Linda, because it's about a long relationship. That's Two of Us, 72. Again from Sgt. Pepper, "Being for the Benefit of Mr. Kite." That's one of those songs when John Lennon wasn't really that inspired. You know, that was the time when he took maybe too much acid, and he was living in the house in Weybridge, according to him, a kind of boring life. And so he had a poster of the Benefit of Mr. Kite. It was a poster he bought in an antiques shop about a festivity in the 19th century. So it's like a flyer to a party of a Mr. Kite, and that's basically those are the lyrics. Musically, it's very interesting, especially the waltz, the backwards waltz. So it's a great psychedelic John Lennon, Sgt. Pepper era song. Next one is 71. "She Said, She Said" from Revolver, 1966. Probably the first, no, maybe the second or third song we've got from Revolver. Of course, one of their best albums ever. "She Said, She Said" is one of the few Beatles songs, and at that time, I think it was the first Beatles song without Paul McCartney on it. That was when they had a big argument. John and I think John and George and Paul had a big argument, and Paul basically told them to fuck off and ran out of this studio, drove home, and I think George played the bass on that song. It was the lyrics inspired by Peter Fonda of Easy Rider fame, but not at that time yet, because I think in August 1965, when they were on tour in America, the Beatles went to a party where people like Peter Fonda were there, and they took lots of acid there. And on his acid trip, Peter Fonda told John Lennon that he knew how it feels to be dead, because he told John Lennon a story that when he was a child, he was in a coma for a few days, and it was of course very trippy and with all that acid, and John got paranoid from that story, like, you know, like a bad trip, and the song is basically about that. And he changed the he to she so that it wasn't too obvious for Peter Fonda that it was about him. Number 70 is "Honey Pie" by Paul McCartney, one of the more lightweight Beatles songs, Paul McCartney songs. I defend those kind of songs. Many people, especially more the John Lennon kind of fans, don't like those songs, but I think they were charming, and you know, there are very very cool ideas in the production of the song, like the intro, like it's an old record from the 1920s, and the string arrangement, it's very, you know, it's a very charming Paul McCartney song. And that was the last one for this episode. Thank you very much.